I'm going to simulate you the pronator teres, okay? So this is the motor point that I thought that it should be. Okay, I'm going to increase. So once you get the intensity, let me increase. Yeah, fine, fair enough. Can you see?
Yes, sir.
I go a little bit more now. You can see that it has already started to pronate, okay?
Yes.
Yeah.
Sir.
Okay?
Yes,
so this
sir.
Is your pronator teres. Yeah, now it's much better. Okay, so this is your pronator teres. Got it? Same motor point. Okay, now I'll go for your flexor carpi radialis. Flexor carpi radialis, when you palpate, remember that's the first tendon when you start from here, okay? In the flexor aspect of the forearm, when you see, I don't know whether I have taught this to all of you. No, it's simple to how to know whether I'm dealing with the flexor carpi radialis. All of you, make a fist. And just what you have to do is keep it in full supination and slightly go into pronation. Can you see your tendon that is standing up?
Yes.
That's the tendon is your flexor carpi
radialis.
Okay, that's your flexor carpi radialis.
Yeah.
Make a fist. Yeah, and then slowly. Yeah, this is your palmaris longus. This is your flexor carpi radialis. The first tendon that is standing out is your flexor carpi radialis, and you can see in her that when she is actually pronating, the first tendon that is standing out is a flexor carpi radialis, and the second tendon, the thinnest, then okay, this is thicker, this will be very thick, and you can see another tendon that is thin, that is your palmaris longus. This is our palmaris longus. Okay, fair enough. In this case, you can see that there is a palmaris longus. You can see in him that there is a palmaris longus is coming up, but not as good as. And you can see that this is your flexor carpi radialis, the tendon that is standing out. Okay. Now, how to palpate is? So I'll be palpating over here, and I'll be intensity zero. Okay, fine. So I'll be stimulating here. Yeah. Yeah. Once you get, let me know. Okay. It started to hurt. Can you increase, please, for me? I hope you can see,
yes,
but
sir.
A lot of ulnaris is coming out. Yeah, that's what. Okay, you can see now. Okay, it is a flexor carpi radialis that it is exactly working. Okay, so it is flexor carpi radialis. Slightly I was down. I told you that I could have been slightly down. When I marked at that time, so I said that I should have been little bit down. So this is what you are, flexor carpi radialis. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to do the flexor digitorum superficialis. Again, how to differentiate superficialis is, superficialis function is to only flex the your proximal IP. Okay, yes please. How to generally anatomically when we say, yeah, yes please, can you bend your yeah, okay, strong, as much as possible strong. Okay, okay, fine. Okay, do it strong, only that. Okay, now can you see? Okay, the distal IP is completely free. The distal IP, that means he is working only with the flexor digitorum superficialis, which is okay, fine. But I cannot do it in my electrical simulation like that. This is just to differentiate that how it is. So I'm going to now put my electrode over here, and I see that predominantly it takes the action starts from the PAP. Of course, it's going to make the other muscles also to work. Okay, it's going to make the other muscles also to work, but I'm going for you. But what I'm going to look at it is, I'm going to look at that whether the action starts from the, okay, because the current is actually, okay, the current is coming from there. Yeah, there. Yeah,
yes.
That's what I said. Okay, that's what I said. Can you see? It is, if now if I reduce my intensity, probably I may isolate, but the current is coming from here, and the current cannot isolatedly come in, so it is crossing the other motor points. So obviously I have to then reduce the intensity. But if I want to show you that, can you see?
Yes.
Predominantly it flexes the, okay, IP. Okay, so that's your flexor digitorum superficialis. Flexor digitorum superficialis. And if we have palmaris longus, it has to be in between. So let us try here. It seems that he is having palmaris longus. Okay, let us see. And again, I am not going for a visible contraction. Ideally, I should have palpated even for the flexor digitorum superficialis, but I wanted to show you a visible contraction. Okay, fair enough. Can you see now?
Yes.
That's what. It is coming in between. And you can see that tendon now starts to, okay, getting up farther then. Okay. So that's your, and you can see that the hand is also going for that movement, you know. Your debut range contracture position, okay. That's your palmaris. Or I would say your mouse holding position. You know, computer may, when you hold your mouse, you generally go into that position and you have hold it, yeah. Not with your, when you hold it like this, okay? When you hold it like this, you will have it. So that's your palmaris longus. Now we are coming for your flexor carpi, sorry, flexor pollicis longus. So flexor pollicis longus is a only muscle that you can get it. And what is the action? This is a pollicis longus. So ideally, it is has to bend your IP, IP of the thumb. No, wait. Can we increase the intensity, please, a little bit? No, this is superficial. Not that much. No, again, not that good. Ideally, I used to get a pure. No, that's what. This is working with the abduction. Ideally, I get the. Can we reduce? Shut.